Atypical antipsychotics. Why do we need atypicals? The major drawback of typical antipsychotics were extrapyramidal side effects, no improvement or even exaggeration of negative and cognitive symptoms of schizophrenia. Because of these major drawbacks of typical antipsychotics, lot of research was going on to design a drug with less extrapyramidal side effects and that would improve both negative as well as cognitive symptoms of schizophrenia. This search ended with newer antipsychotics, otherwise called as atypical or second generation antipsychotics. These drugs are called atypical because they do not act by blocking the dopamine receptors. They have other mechanisms of action like weaker D2 blocking action or rapid dissociation from the dopamine receptors, dopamine partial agonism, serotonin partial agonism, serotonin dopamine antagonism. Now let's try to understand how these different mechanisms help in reducing the extrapyramidal side effects of these antipsychotic agents. Firstly, let's see how serotonin partial agonism and serotonin dopamine antagonism reduce the extrapyramidal side effects. Drugs with 5-HT2A antagonistic and 5-HT1A partial agonistic action increase dopamine in the nigrostriatal and tuberoinfundibular pathway without affecting dopamine in the mesolimbic pathway. By increasing dopamine in the nigrostriatal and tuberoinfundibular pathway, they reduce chances of extrapyramidal side effects as well as that of hyperprolactinemia. But since they do not affect dopamine in the mesolimbic pathway, the antipsychotic efficacy of these drugs are not compromised. Apart from this, some of these atypical agents have additional 5-HT6 antagonistic action. It is noted that 5-HT6 receptor plays a key role in regulation of acetylcholine release. By improving acetylcholine release, these drugs improve the cognitive symptoms of schizophrenia. Some drugs have additional 5-HT7 antagonistic action as well, and this helps in reducing depression. You can note that serotonin dopamine antagonism and serotonin partial agonism helps in reducing the extrapyramidal side effects and also in improving the cognitive symptoms, and it has some antidepressant action as well. How does dopamine partial agonism reduce extrapyramidal side effects? Dopamine partial agonism means it has an intrinsic activity between that of an antagonist and an agonist. That is an intrinsic activity between 0 and 1. This means this drug act like an agonist when the dopamine concentrations are low and act like an antagonist when the dopamine concentrations are high. This means in the nigrostriatal pathway where the dopamine concentration is low, these drugs act like agonist, whereas in the mesolimbic pathway where the dopamine concentration is high, these drugs act like an antagonist. Though these drugs have so many positives, the main drawback of atypical antipsychotic is metabolic syndrome. Nine include esinapine, aripiprazole, ziprasidone, risperidone and paliperidone. Risperidone and paliperidone can cause hyperprolactinemia. Drugs which can cause QTC prolongation, they are the same drugs, that is esinapine, aripiprazole, ziprasidone and paliperidone. Along with that you have quetiapine and amyl sulfuride.